Hello, hello. Welcome back to Let's Talk Ray Bradbury. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please do. We are nearing 1,400 subscribers, and with your help, we can get there very, very soon. So today, continuing our review series on Bradbury stories, we are down to story number 96 of 100, so we are just about to the end of this thing. Today's story is Getting Through Sunday Somehow. This is another one of Bradbury's Dublin, Ireland set stories. Here, once again, an American writer is staying in Dublin while he works, but he wakes up one Sunday morning in winter. It is cold, it is foggy, and he sort of regrets even getting up at all, because apparently Sunday mornings this time in Dublin are very lazy times. This boredom permeates everything. But he does manage to get himself up. He goes down the street to a local pub, and he has a pint of Guinness with a rather dour old man sort of drooling over his glass, sort of ranting about the guilt of not being more giving. And the older he gets, the more he takes, the less joy he gives out into the world, and the less thanks he actually gives for the things that he takes in, the beauty of the sunsets, the small things you wouldn't necessarily think of as gifts, but, you know, the gift of being allowed to live yet another day. He eventually makes his way out of the pub, and he walks down the block where he first hears and then later meets an older lady playing a harp. Her playing lifts his spirits immediately, and he feels inclined to shower her with praise. He tells her how good she is and that she could play professionally in a concert hall if she chose to. She, of course, says this is ridiculous, and she tells him a story about how her father made this harp and basically, you know, warned him, don't play in a theater, in the stuffy confines of a theater. Play outdoors where the music can be set free, and sort of very romantic notions like that. But his praise momentarily sort of throws off her balance, and where previously she'd been playing effortlessly and not even really looking at her fingers and just wandering, sort of watching the landscape and people passing by and taking inspiration from that. But suddenly she stumbles a little bit, and she sort of chides him for that. But ultimately he walks away, and as he sort of gets around the corner, headed back to the pub to sort of, he wants to talk to that same old man again if he has a chance. He listens and hears that she sort of finds her balance and her equilibrium in her music making again, sort of it retakes that sense of effortlessness. So obviously this is another one of Bradbury's sort of Irish-based set stories. He did spend time living in Ireland. staying in Ireland, rather, while he was working on the script of, I want to say, Moby Dick. And there's many stories that came out of that period for him, some sort of more realistic, others more fantastic, like The Banshee. But really, this is about an ambitious American, when an ambitious American mind comes up against sort of the nonchalance of Irish culture at the time, I guess. Our country's, don't look a whole lot different, really, and there's sort of millions of people of Irish descent here, but we really move at different paces. There's really a drive here, an expectation of sort of like using every minute, and although we spend a lot of time being lazy, thinking about doing things, ultimately, but still there's this sense that it's preferable to always be moving, always be doing things, always expressing things. Probably talking a little bit too much as well. but the story, not a masterpiece. As far as I'm concerned, not great. But it does at least give me a little something for my mind to gnaw on as I go about my own day. Trying to apply what I read to life. And in this case, I'm about to head out on a trail run. And what I take away from this story is that I should probably, try to be thankful and enjoy the run for its own sake, and maybe not be so concerned about the end goal of getting into better shape and some such shit like that, that has a way of clouding the beauty of the daily process. And that's what I'm going to take away from getting through Sunday somehow, although it is Friday. All right, guys, getting through Sunday somehow. Have you read this story? Please drop a positive or constructive comment in the comment section below. Either way, give this video a thumbs up. That always helps. And we will be back shortly with the next review, which is the Pumpernickel. That will get us down to number 97 of 100 before we move on to our next project here on Let's Talk. So thank you, and I will see you again soon, probably Saturday, maybe Monday. Either way, have a good weekend.